afternoon, St. Matthew family and friends. My name is Michael Brown, and I joined St. Matthew in 1969 with my wife. We were newlyweds, and we joined under Reverend Booker T. Cartwright. Reverend Cartwright was a friend of Diane's father, so she knew him. So that's how we came to visit here and fell in love with St. Matthew right away. After Reverend Cartwright was reappointed, Reverend Frank Williams came. And before we could get to know him real well, he passed in 6 months, after 6 months of coming to St. Matthew. He died from a massive heart attack. And then after Reverend Frank Williams came Reverend Leroy Adams. And that is when we really, really began to grow in the church and grow in Christ. We spent a lot of time with Reverend Adams and his family. James and Ruth Dees were our friends, and St. Matthew called us the youngsters. Can you believe it? We were in our 20s, newly married, but we were dedicated members of this church and very active. We love St. Matthew because it had some extraordinary people. Back in those days, I can remember Forrest Dreher and his wife, Curry, Albert Hunter and his wife, Sylvia. They were excellent role models for us as a newly married couple. Spent a lot of time with Brother Dreher and Brother Hunter. Brother Dreher was the chairman of the building fund. And back in those days, the emphasis was on building a new and bigger St. Matthew. I can remember having the church having elaborate teas as fundraisers. I can remember also the dedication of the officers, particularly the stewards and the trustees. There was Steward Mamie Porter and her husband Glover Porter, who was a trustee. I can remember Steward Sarah Tate. There was Mary Tynes and her husband Charles. This is before before she went into the ministry. Thelma Jones, who was the church treasurer at the time. Then there was Gail Brown and her husband John T. Gail was the church secretary. But these were some fine and dedicated folks. Brother Eddie Cunningham and his wife Edith, they are the grandparents of Brian. I can remember Brian running around here as a young boy. There are such great, great memories and such great dedicated people. After Reverend Adams was appointed to New England, then came Reverend Charles Martin, and Reverend Charles Martin had a family, so we were able to interact with him and his family. But I can remember St. Matthew back in those days was affectionately called the Little Cathedral, and we had a divided chancel. The church was a little brick building, set back off the street, and we had a huge, huge oak tree in the front. And when we were making plans for building, We were trying to determine what we were going to do with this oak tree. And what happened was we actually built the building around so that it did not disturb the huge oak tree. But I learned a lot from the dedicated members back then. And as I look over the years, and it's been over 50 years that I've been a member of St. Matthew now, that those dedicated folks live on in other new members that have come and gone since then. God has a way of raising up dedicated people to do His work, people that love Him. And I have enjoyed serving with them. And I'd be remiss if I didn't mention Reverend John Jackson, who served at least under five pastors. And what I admire so much about Reverend John Jackson is he was a historian in his own right. And also what I really loved about him is how he worked with the pastors that I knew, starting with Reverend Cartwright, through Reverend Williams, through Reverend Addles, through Reverend Charles Martin in the 70s. How he worked with them and how he supported his pastor and how he kept such a loving spirit. And in times of crisis, it was Reverend John Jackson who took St. Matthew into the annual conference as acting pastor. So it was through the dedication of these fine people that I am so proud to share the heritage and be a part and sit under a lot of them and learn so much from them. So St. Matthew has been blessed over the years. It's been a joyous journey that I've been on, and God continues to raise up people to do His work. St. Matthew, we've had a glorious past. We are going through a future, excuse me, we are going through a present that is a journey, that's truly a Christian journey, and we look forward to a glorious future. Amen.